In this video lecture, we'll explore connecting to the SQL Server using the SQL Server Management Studio client and making sure that the SQL Server service is running. All right, so let's start by trying to run SQL Server Management Studio. And here's the link to the SQL Server 2014 Management Studio. And it will load. And when it loads, you'll try and connect by default to whatever instance you last connected to, or you can enter the instance name and the credentials, or if you're using Windows authentication and your current account is the one that is used to authenticate, that's fine. You can go ahead and connect. Let's try and connect here. And this is indeed CIS-117 is the SQL Server instance on my computer. And I try and connect and nothing happens and nothing happens. And after a moment, it's going to time out. And at this point, you're probably scratching your head going, well, you know I installed it correctly and it worked previously, and now what's the deal? Why is it not connecting? Why did it time out? You may get a cannot connect, and the detail may be here a network related or instance specific error. Most common 26 error locating server instance specified. If that comes up, what has happened is that you probably elected not to have your server run as a dedicated server. If it's running on a local workstation, you only want to use the memory and process the CPU cycles for that SQL server when you're actually running it. And so it's probably set not to start automatically. So here's how we can check and see if that instance is running. I'm going to go ahead and launch the control panel. And I'll come up to Administrative Tools and come down to Services. And I know that that process is named SQL Server. So if I just click into the list of processes and type S, we'll come down and I'll see SQL Server CIS-117. Aha, it is not one of the running processes and it's started manually. So let's go ahead and start that. If I right click on it and tell it start, after a moment it should kick over and the process will be running, and then I'll have something to connect to. So problem solved. That catches a lot of folks out, so keep that one in mind. So I'm done with my services. It's now showing it's running. Let's go ahead and go back here to our SQL Server Management Studio and tell it to connect now, and very promptly it does indeed connect. Our next lecture will address how do we go ahead and get those databases created. Thanks for watching.